cat. Okay, it's me and my kinfolk. Cat, that is my MO. 9 to 5.
Welcome, football fans, to the birthplace of America, the city of brotherly love. The place where you'll find the best cheesesteak made in this country and some of the best football played inside of Lincoln Financial Field. Jake Elliott is out and ready to kick this one away. And we're underway from Philadelphia. And this will be a touchback, so we're going to need our first snap to see the first action of this game. All right, let's get this show on the road. It is first and 10. Right to the air, it's Levis. Has him on the quick hitter. And he'll push this upfield and earn them a new set of downs.
Good offenses. Okay, good play callers know how to utilize their personnel. They know where they wanted him. They wanted him on a route in space where he could make that initial play comfortably, but then go to work after him.
And into a sea of bodies he goes. Looks like they'll get about 3 out of it.
Hey, we know running the ball in the NFL is hard, and that play pretty indicative of it. Here's the key, though. At the end of the game, those type of plays got to be in the minority, and the majority have got to do some damage.
Second down now, 7 to go.
Hey, come on, come on. Hey, 24 Linus, back to the team green.
Again, a run with Pollard. And they get there to take him down right around the 41. And that one goes for a gain of 11. And the Titans will have a first down.
Ooh, I like that. I really like that execution to move the chains. Now that third down call that they had ready, well, they could stick it right back in the pocket for a later occasion.
First and 10 from the 41.
Like 54.
Shotgun now for Levis. That one is incomplete. Couldn't hang on through the contact. Gonna have to wait a little longer for his first catch of the game. And we'll see what they do here on second down.
Timing is everything in life, and timing is everything defensively. That throw was just a little bit late and gave the defense time to close, deliver a pop, and knock that ball loose.
The give on second to Pollard. He still has room inside the 30. And he has this all the way down to the 17-yard line. It's a 24-yard gash, and it gives them the first down.
Those outside runs so critical for running back, quarterback, O-line to hit their targets. They got a target area to expose that defense and make the most of it. And that offense just put on display some teaching tape for it.
Escapes the pocket. That's brought in by Calvin Ridley. And they bring him down at the 7-yard line. Offense up to the line fast. They give to Pollard from the gun. And his short gain gets them a new set of downs. His drive has been excellent. A few shots now. It's starting with 6 as they come up on it. First and goal. Levis from the shotgun. He's on the move. And he pushes it all the way to the goal line, but goes out at the 1.
Well, the QB made something happen and got some yardage when the play didn't develop right, and even got himself out of bounds to avoid a hit. The only negative at all is he couldn't quite get the first down.
Now it's 2nd and goal from the 1. Pollard. Goes up and over for the touchdown. The Titans finish up an excellent opening series. Tony Pollard with the touchdown.
Well, you couldn't ask for a better start to a game than that. The offense taking it all
the way down the field and finishing with six.
These opening drives, Kate, are such tone setters. It is why every offense loves to script their first 15 plays, right? Everybody knows what's coming, allows you during the practice week to get into rhythm, but even better when you're that sharp, that crisp, and you finish off and get the early lead.
Stonehouse now to kick this one away. And he wasn't chancing a return there, putting it out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. First and 10 now from the 30. Starting on the ground here with Barkley. Cuts it to the right sideline. Big gainer here as he picks up 20. And that's a Philadelphia first down. Only one play in, Brock, and this drive already to midfield.
No touch that.
First and 10 at the 50-yard line.
And time runs out before they get the snap off. That's the end of one. Neither side separating much so far. We'll return to the link right after this. Ready now for our second quarter. The Eagles have the football.
63,
they'll try to attack this deficit starting with first and 10.
Hey, Silver. Crowd left, Yeti. No touch.
Hurts looking to throw. And oh, someone stepped in. It's intercepted. Jamal Adams with the INT. And the Titans take possession just shy of midfield following the interception and the lengthy return.
A lot of defenders got some offense in their background, and it's been my life experience that they'll tell you about it. And right there, he put it on display. He brought in the pick and instantly became a runner, searching for the open field to add a little something-something to the return.
Good starting field position for the Titans. They've got it, first and 10. They'll start this one on the ground with Pollard. And his effort results in maybe 2 yards, but nothing more.
I think one thing you learn, Kate, when you transition from college to the NFL, not every run is going to be a big play. Some of them, well, they're just destined to end in a minimal gain, and some of them will set up that critical play action for later.
8 yards to go. Well, let's see how they approach this second down. From the gun, Levis. That's going to be caught, Tony Pollard. And he stopped cold at the spot. Ooh, he paid for that one, but hey, still enough for that first down.
That's just great instincts. Go air it out on second down rather than just play conservative and run it. They hit a weak point in the coverage and don't need to worry about third down at all.
They'll head up first and 10 from the 42. Hand off running right, Pollard. And not much doing, he stopped quickly. Only 2 yards and it brings up second and 8. Now Levis. Chased out to his right. Catch is made down the right sideline. And he pushes this down to the 22-yard line. That'll go for an 18-yard gain. And that'll be a Tennessee first down.
I'm sure coach and play caller doesn't mind making the job a little bit easier. You know, play calling's a lot simpler and easier when you count on the offense to move the chains on those early downs.
To the line we go. They're set, first and 10.
Like 54.
Levis back to throw. Getting out to his left. Caught near the goal line. And he gets the first down before being taken down. Pollard goes up and over for the touchdown. The Titans grow their lead just before halftime. Tony Pollard with the touchdown. It's what every player who scores a touchdown wants to do, Brock. He wants to get right back there and put another six on the board.
I've never met an NFL player content with one end zone trip in a game.
Nope.
Yeah, if you're content, you're not making it to this league. You get one, you instantly think of another, and the fortunate few are able to actually deliver on it.
Stonehouse now to kick this one away. And it bounces out of the end zone, so they'll set up shop at the 30. They're out and set, first and 10. Interception last drive doesn't deter them. They're going right back to the air. That pass caught by Dotson. And that's good yardage with a new set of downs.
I love throwing on first down. And when you see a first down pass just like that, it's taking advantage of a matchup you plan for, and you go out and execute.
First down throwing for Hurts. Gets everything he has under this throw. That's cut at the 25. And he's out of bounds right at the 25-yard line. They're now set for first and 10. Throwing here hurts. An alert play defensively there. He got a hand on it to tip it away. That makes it second down.
I think we're starting to get a feel, aren't we, of why they like him so much in coverage. He reacts well to throws, is super adept at breaking up passes through contact, or like that one before they could ever reach the target.
On second down, here's Barkley. And he's caught behind the line for a loss. Timeout taken by the Eagles. That's going to be their first. Wonder what's in the playbook here as they come up on third and 11.
Go Silver, ready? Hey, 73.
Back to throw, Hurts. Pocket isn't holding up. They're able to drop it. And the defense comes through to back him up ahead of fourth down. Philadelphia going to spend its second timeout. And they still have one in their pocket for what's left of this half. Fourth and forever coming up.
Don't touch that. Yeti, Yeti.
On fourth down, Hurts. That's caught beyond the marker. And he's brought down real close to that goal line at the one. Now the offense going to take its third and final timeout. And that's all they've got for what little remains of this half. So after that big play, Brock, they need just that final yard here on first and goal. Didn't get that one off in time. This is going to be a delay of game. Must have lost sight of the play clock there, Brock, because the quarterback could have snapped it in time, but instead, they take the penalty. First and goal, now 5 yards tougher after that penalty.
Great, 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 set, hey!
Hurts to throw. Falls to the ground out left, incomplete.
Just something off in the rhythm of their passing game on that one. Time to recalibrate and keep throwing it to get back into rhythm.
So the incompletion on first, here's second and goal.
No touch that. Hey, easy, 63, bad. Hey, silver.
Hurts setting up to throw. Oh, this is getting ugly early. Intercepted again. Jamal Adams with the INT. And the Titans might be able to get some points late after the interception.
You know what this is, Kate? This is the practice field coming to life. Really on both sides of the ball. Well, you watch defensive coaches preach all the time, and they work on these returns to get to the near sideline, everybody to get a block, and then for those offensive players to show the effort to go chase that down so it's not a pick six. Yeah, it stinks for the offense, but that was the practice field coming to life for everybody to see.
That pass complete to Boyd. And they're going to haul him down a step before the 30, right at the 31. Just before halftime, we get a timeout taken. Now it's Nick Folk to try the Titans field goal. Ball on the right hash, 48 yards out. It's close and no good. It connects with that left upright. So we finished two quarters. A couple more to come after this short break. More of the NFL on EA Sports after this. Welcome back, everybody. Kate Scott, Brock Heward with you as we're about set to begin the third quarter. Stonehouse now to kick this one away. And we'll have to wait at least a few moments longer for an exciting start to this second half. We've got a touchback. First and 10 now from the 30.
Don't touch that. Silver, set. Hey, 73. Don't touch it.
Hand off headed right, Barkley. He's off to the races. Into the red zone. He does it. Touchdown, Philadelphia. The Eagles cut into the lead coming out of halftime. Saquon Barkley, the touchdown. Wow, just sensational speed from the back that time, Brock. He found a seam, got through it, and he was gone.
You know, it's one thing, Kate, to have singles hitters, right? And you love those, and you appreciate guys right. That can get on base. But it's the home run hitters that are the difference makers, and what a big-time effort.
So following the missed point after, a chance to take his frustrations out on that football as he sends this away. And that's over the 20, the landing zone, and almost everything else. So that football coming out to the 30-yard line. They'll get this drive started. First and 10.
They like 13.
Up the middle, here goes Pollard. And the defense gets there to force a small loss.
Well, he was supposed to be the one who chipped away a few. He got a new set of downs started right in rhythm. Instead, he's now forced to pick himself from behind the line thanks to a great effort defensively.
Short pass brought in. Continuing to move past the 45. And that's good yardage there with a new set of downs to boot. New set of downs for him from the 46. First and 10, it's Pollard. And he reaches midfield and starts driving into Eagles territory. A nice 6-yard pickup. They're going to have second and 4. Right back to Pollard. And he's dropped just short of the marker, maybe a yard away.
Okay, that's a run that's ho-hum on the stat sheet, but if you see a bigger play on the ground later on, it'll largely be because of a play just like that one, softening up the front and opening the door for a bigger gap in the future.
Here he is to throw on 3rd and 2. Pass is hauled in by the running back. Call it 7 yards on the play, and that's enough for the first down. Who set it down for him at the 38? Hand up, running left, Pollard. Jukes one defender, and he gets this one down to the 30-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup, and they're going to have 2nd and 2 next.
Well, that doesn't net a first down. You get yards like that in the run game, you will take it in the NFL.
Trying the inside handoff to Pollard, and he's brought down for a loss. We'll see what they come up with for 3rd down in just a bit. We've reached the end of 3. The Titans have it with the lead. Just got to hang on for a little bit longer. Chance to move the chains here on 3rd and 4. He's back to throw. That throw's knocked away and incomplete. 4th down coming up.
With all due respect to some of the great linebackers back in the day, to play the position today, man, you've got to be versatile. You can't just be a come up and stuff the run. You got to play coverage. And these defenses more and more rely on you to break up throws just like that.
Down pass didn't work, but the offense staying out there on 4th. Looking to throw. Pass caught by Ridley. They come through with 6 yards there, Brock, and they're rewarded with a new set of downs.
I love those moments of truth. We get to see exactly how they handle it when all the pressure of the drive's right on them. Turns out, handled it pretty darn well, and now they'll keep pushing on.
And they've got themselves another 1st and 10. From the gun, they go with Pollard. And he stopped just before he reaches the red zone at the 21. 1st down play, nets him 5. It's going to be 2nd and 5. Here we go. This is Pollard running left. And he's going to be stopped at the 17-yard line. A 4-yard pickup, and they're just inches shy as we reach 3rd down.
49.
So that brings us to the 2-minute warning in Philly. Titans leading by 8. Here we go, 3rd and less than a yard. On the give, this is Pollard. And he's tackled with the 1st down yardage.
That is your old school meat and potatoes call right there. Don't even think about throwing it. Just rush it ahead and get what you need.
A touchdown would put this one to bed. A few shots at it here, starting with 1st and goal. On the carry, this is Pollard. And they beat him to the edge. That run stopped back at the line. No gain that time, and now it'll be 2nd and goal.
You know, Kate, these are the situations in training camp that I love more than anything to watch. You learn so much about a football team in these goal-to-go situations. You know you got to protect that goal line, and the defense, well, they did the job on 1st down. More to come.
And he's able to get it to the 2 before the stop. Give him 6 yards. That's going to set up 3rd and goal.
Well, you haven't given up the goal line yet, but this offense is moving closer and closer. Now might be the time defensively to get a little more aggressive, try to stick them with the loss, and make a difficult fourth down decision.
So now, here's third and goal.
Like 49!
Pollard goes up and over for the touchdown. The Titans lead by 14.